T-minus 15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mission and liftoff of Transporter 4.
Pitching downrange.
Stage 1, chamber pressure is nominal.
We're at T plus 40 seconds. Awesome views from Falcon 9 punching through the clouds. Falcon 9 has cleared the tower and we're currently throttling down in preparation for max Q at T plus 1 minute and 12 seconds. This is where the stage will experience the maximum aerodynamic pressure. MVAC engine on the second stage will ignite. Carrying
start of MVAC engine chill.
You heard the call out for the start of that MVAC engine chill prior, getting ready for that second engine start of. Really cool plumes from Falcon 9. We're under 30 seconds to main engine cutoff. Have separated from the vehicle, exposing the 4D spacecraft to the vacuum of space. Now, today's mission marks the first flight for both of those fairing halves, and we will be attempting to recover those from the water once they fall back down to Earth. Now, we're currently in our first of three MVAC burns. Now, this first burn should last until about T plus 10 minutes. Those white puffs of gas that you may occasionally see from this first stage are from the attitude control system, and those are nitrogen gas. That's nitrogen gas that's coming out and helps with attitude control of the first stage as it makes its way back down to Earth.
Stage 2 FDS is saved.
We're about 3 minutes from the start of our stage 1 entry burn. Again, this is a three-engine burn, and there are three engines in a row on the first stage, which will light up to slow the vehicle down as it enters the upper parts of the Earth's atmosphere.
Thank you.
20-second burn of the single
engine. Orbit insertion.
As you can see, we did have a successful landing of our first stage, as well as a confirmation of a nominal second stage orbit in the middle there. Now, coming up in about 5 minutes, we are expecting the start of the deployment sequence. There will be 20 deployments of 40 spacecraft, which will occur over a 73-minute period of time. Now, this includes CubeSats, MicroSats, PicoSats, non-deploying hosted payloads, and an orbital transfer vehicle carrying spacecraft to be deployed at a later time. Now,